Okay. Hey guys, ozani ngapha na indaba. Come this side. It has been there's a something is happening with MK Party. MK Party has been taken to court after some of the members were taken away from parliament, right? So it's going to be argued in court as to when MK Party decided to do that. Was it wrong or right? 10 out of the MK Party members who were removed from parliament were, look, 10 out of them filed for court. But there is more to the story than what meets the eye. And it is that which is important, which we need to talk about. What is it? We need to talk about the fact that it has been revealed that some of those people who were removed by the MK Party from parliament, some of them were bribed, and one of them received a polo from the ANC. Why? Because it has been said that it is because the ANC wanted them to disrupt MK Party from within. Do you remember the story of disrupting political parties from within? Uh-huh. It appears like it's something, guys, that is on the trend, that a lot of people have not picked this thing up. I don't know why, but we must spend our time talking about this new trend of one political party that has been accused of doing these things. You know what I'm saying? All around. There's just one political party that has been accused, and that's the ANC. They've been accused of, you remember that in the EFF, there's similar accusation. When I was doing the video of Julius Malema, about Julius Malema, I spoke about this thing to say, these people have been accused of that. Do you remember that there was a story about them in the formation of EATM, they were penetrating it from within. Do you remember that MK Party is not the first time they accused the ANC from trying to do the same thing? Many a times they've accused the ANC of trying to do the same thing, right? Of trying to break the party from within, because obviously, if you want to break the party from without, it's going to be difficult. So you need to penetrate them from within. They have been accused. At some point, the accusation went as far as saying that the man that was involved in that, it was Dr. Mkhize, he was accused in that mixed, right? You'll remember some of the videos where I brought some articles where I was proving that, hey, this man has been accused. Videos, I've inserted them in some of my videos to say this man has been accused of masterminding how they are going to penetrate MK from within. So the story continues, and it now gives context why MK Party decided to withdraw some of the members from parliament. But before we can get there, this is what you need to do. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, let's proceed. There's a news house. I don't know. Hey, they are called Scroller. One of their journalists is a guy by the name of Sihle Mavuso. He's very big on Twitter. Listen to this one. This story was written by Celani Skakane. The Umkhonto we Sizwe party is facing backlash from the members who the party fired from parliament. 10 of them filed court papers on Monday to challenge their removal from National Assembly, including Tami Khuzwayo, who was a leader of the student command of the party. Now, pay attention to this. He was also accused by Kanyile of being bribed with Paulo Vivo by the ANC Deputy President David Mabuza to remove Jacob Zuma from the leadership position of MK Party. Did you hear that? Look, if you have noticed, I did say in my video that I have a problem with how things are unfolding, in that it appears to me that there's always one party. I've never heard EFF being accused of bribing a certain political party, penetrating them, destroying them by that. I've never heard DA accused of that. I've never heard, I wouldn't talk about MK Party. I've never heard ATM accused of that, PAC accused of that. It's always one party that is accused of the same offense, guys. Now it's starting to bother me to say, maybe we need to pay attention to this. Just listen to this one. He was also accused by Kanyile of being bribed with a Paulo Vivo by the ANC Deputy President David Mabuza to remove Jacob Zuma from the leadership position of the MK Party. At some point, I said to the MK Party, the removal of these members must be explained. But I guess now we are beginning to see certain now makes sense why they were removed. But let's proceed. Other applications are Isaac Manyato, Mpo Machajo, Augustine Madala, Kweta, Grace Mkwebi, and Mbenhle Mkhize, Banlo, Mtholeni Masilela, Bongani Mfiki, Senzo Dlamini, and Agnes Makgotsi. It is not clear whether the other 8 MK Party members are unceremoniously removed from Parliament are in support of the decision to go to court. Scroller is in possession of the papers filed in the Western Cape High Court on Monday morning. Khuzwayo has already revealed that even before they were removed, they were emotionally abused, threatened as outcast in the corridors of parliament by their MK comrade. Oh, okay. This gives something. It says something, guys. Let's proceed, though. MK spokesperson Hlamulo Ndlela stated that those who were removed put their names in parliament list fraudulently. Yo! He says they even included the name of Zuma, which was not part of the plan. He said plan was to destroy Zuma in parliament in a way that destroyed impeached former judge Hlophe. Ndlela said they have opened a case against the members. He also accused them of putting their relatives on the list of parliaments. Yarr. You know what? Now it's beginning to make a lot of sense. Now I understand. Remember that I accused MK Party for not being being open in terms of why people are getting fired, because it really doesn't make sense why a lot of people are getting fired. But now it is beginning to make a lot of sense, and now I understand. I understand why they did what they did. Jablan Kumalo says they have no intelligence, discredit them. Now it beginning, something is beginning to make sense to say, maybe they have real intelligence. For the fact that Jablan Khumalo doesn't feel comfortable about their intelligence, maybe they have got the real intelligence. It's quite interesting. It's really quite interesting. So there's more that is happening also within MK Party, as well as there's more that is happening within EFF. So political parties are fighting from within. Hey, okay. See you on the next video.